earlier today, I rode on a helicopter to within 4 miles of the burn location, about as close as we could get, and the enormity of the situation in the Gulf was immediately clear.
So we're about 4 miles out from the original burn location now, after about an hour of travel by helicopter, and this is what's left. Today's burn really didn't amount to much of a lasting burn. We saw it on the horizon on the way over here, probably from about 45 minutes out, and by the time we got here, this is what was left, just some remnants of a giant plume of smoke. There are still several Coast Guard vessels down in the water that remain in this area, and several other vessels off in the distance. But as far as this burn goes, it's over for today, at least for now. And until you get on top of this, you can't really understand the enormity of it and see how wide-reaching this oil spill is. Really, to burn off the oil in this spill is going to be quite a challenge. I know there are reports that say between 50 and 85% of oil is usually burned off when something like this takes place. But it's going to be quite a tall order to burn off that much oil as widespread as this is. One other thing you notice when you get above here is the smell. We're flying at about 2,000 feet above the oil spill, and as soon as we got above the oil, you could smell crude below. It was a very pungent smell and a very noticeable smell. But once again, this is all that's left of today's burn. What was done today, as far as we can tell, didn't last very long.
There is more exclusive video on WDSU.com right now that I shot with my iPhone while in the helicopter accompanying that video. And we were, again, about 2,000 feet above the oil spill.